So let's take a look at more accessibility features on your Mac that could be useful to anyone. We're going to go in System Preferences and then Accessibility, and I'm going to go down to Keyboard. And there are two sets of settings here, Hardware and Accessibility Keyboard. Let's look at Hardware first. The first thing you've got here is something called Sticky Keys. So let's look in the options for Sticky Keys. Sticky Keys are the ability to be able to use modifier keys like the Command Key, Option, Control, and Space without having to hold them down. So instead of, say, pressing and holding Command and C, you can press Command, release it, and then press C to get the same option. You can toggle this on or off with pressing the Shift key 5 times if you want. So a way to get this on or off without having to go into System Preferences. You can have it do a sound when a modifier key is set and display which keys, which modifier keys are active in a corner. So let's do the top left here. So I'll enable Sticky Keys. So before, if I wanted to bring up, say, search the Help menu, I could hold the Command key, hold the Shift key, and press the slash key that has the question mark above it to do it. But with Sticky Keys on, I can tap the Command key, and you can see it appears there in the upper left. Then I'll tap the Shift key, and that appears. Now I'm not holding any keys now, and I could tap the slash key, and it actually does the action. So that could be useful to just about anybody that wants maybe a different experience there using the keyboard and these modifier keys. Now, slow keys is a simpler concept. Basically, it allows you to, if you tap a key on the keyboard, nothing will happen. You actually have to tap and hold. So this is useful if you accidentally hit the keyboard a lot and you don't want to have every touch on the keyboard actually be a press. Now, there are a couple of useful things in here. If you set it to short, then the keyboard won't really behave any differently. But you can turn on Use Key Click Sounds, and now your Mac will sound like a typewriter as you type things. So let's bring up TextEdit here. So you get these little sounds going on. Depends if I actually set a little bit of a delay and I try to type, nothing happens and I get these little stunted sounds. But if I slowly type, press down each key, like almost like it's a mechanical keyboard, then I can type. So it could be useful for some people. So let's turn that off and go to the Accessibility Keyboard. So the Accessibility Keyboard is really useful if something's wrong with your actual physical keyboard. This happens from time to time. I hear about people saying their keyboard's not working, they want to troubleshoot it, maybe it's a Bluetooth keyboard, but without the keyboard it's very difficult to do it. You can actually bring up an on-screen keyboard. I'll enable it here and you can see a keyboard appears. And I can actually use my mouse, use the cursor here to type. So here I am in TextEdit and you can see I can type with it. So not a great experience in general, but if your keyboard's not working for some reason, then you can use this to get a few key commands going on, just get something happening, so at least you can use your Mac until you figure out what's wrong with the keyboard.